You anticipate the car to move when you press the gas pedal. What occurs then when the car won't accelerate but the RPMs increase? It is important to address this issue right away, but where do you begin? In this video, we discuss the main causes of acceleration-related problems. We also look at how to repair car issues without being a qualified mechanic. And for now, we will start with the reasons of car won't accelerate. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Bad torque converter. To convert the mechanical power coming from the engine into the hydraulic power required for the drivetrain, a torque converter is required. You can hear the transmission shuddering when it first begins to fail. Additionally, it results in a rise in RPMs without any acceleration. The transmission won't receive enough power if the torque converter fails. As a result, despite the rising RPMs, it will be difficult for you to reach the desired speed. Slipping transmission. When a transmission slips, it is unable to engage or shift gears as it usually would. The general term slipping transmission typically denotes a more serious internal issue. A lack of transmission fluid is one simple issue that can result in a slipping transmission. Even burned transmission fluid, which is typically brought on by overheating, may be at fault. In addition to these issues, the transmission's clutches might be worn. Many of the additional issues we will address later can result in a slipping transmission. Bad shift solenoids. The fluid flow in the transmission is managed by the shift solenoid. The solenoids are instructed when to transfer fluid by an electrical signal that is sent by the transmission control module. The check engine light ought to come on if there is a solenoid or circuit issue. Additionally, you'll notice jerky shifting, slipping, or a failure to increase RPMs. The vehicle could also enter a limp mode to stop any further damage from happening. Worn clutch. Do you operate a manual transmission vehicle? If so, the clutch might be the cause of the issue. The clutch will eventually fail after many miles of use. The transmission begins to slip as the clutch disc ages. When you press the gas pedal, it might feel unresponsive as well. Damaged gearbox. You will experience many of the same issues with a manual gearbox's failure as you would with an automatic transmission. There may be strange sounds or a startling grinding sound. Additionally, the transmission might get stuck in one gear. Additionally, there may be a problem with the gearbox if you have trouble shifting the car into gear or notice significant fluid leakage. Drivetrain problems. The drivetrain may be at fault if the transmission or associated parts aren't the problem. For instance, a broken axle shaft might prevent the wheels from turning. Before a vehicle has any difficulty moving at all, drivetrain problems typically start out as some kind of vibration or shaking. It may be challenging to distinguish transmission problems from other noises, such as clunking or grinding. How to fix? When you identify a problem with your car, you should act right away. Many issues are easily resolved, but waiting too long could damage your transmission. You only need a few basic tools and a working knowledge of mechanics for many of these tasks. Here are the steps we recommend. Check trouble codes and TCM. There should be a diagnostic code set in the computer if the check engine or transmission light is on. All gas-powered vehicles built in 1996 or later are equipped with the OBD2 system. You can read this information using a code reader that is compatible. Connect the scanner and observe the codes that appear. To identify the issue and correct the fault, use any trouble code library. Check transmission fluid level. Not all automobiles have a checkable transmission. Some contemporary cars have sealed transmissions that should only be serviced by the dealer. Change transmission fluid. Depending on the manufacturer's recommendation, the transmission fluid may need to be changed every 60,000 to 100,000 miles. Furthermore, not all transmission manufacturers provide serviceable models, so you might not be able to perform the fluid change yourself. Don't forget to properly dispose of your used fluid. You just need to look into what's available in your neighborhood to see which auto parts stores offer free fluid recycling. It's crucial to follow the instructions for your specific car model with a repair manual because the fluid change procedure may vary depending on the model of your vehicle. Diagnose the clutch system. You can try to diagnose the clutch on your own if you understand how the manual transmission works. If the clutch does not disengage at all, either a bad slave cylinder or a broken linkage or cable may be to blame. A failed friction plate, pressure plate diaphragm, or throwout bearing are other possibilities. However, if the clutch slips while under load, there is frequently not much that can be adjusted or fixed. You might just have a bad clutch disc and a worn-out flywheel friction surface. Another possibility is a leaky seal. Diagnose the drivetrain. The drivetrain's diagnostics can be a little trickier. To begin, perform a visual examination of each component to check for wear. In addition, it is best to adhere to the directions provided in your service manual. Troubleshooting may be manufacturer-specific. Contact a professional. There is a good chance that these issues will be too challenging to solve. You might require more assistance if it's not as straightforward as adding or replacing transmission fluid. Reach out to a local technician in your area that specializes in transmission repair. You can significantly reduce your downtime by paying someone else to take care of the issue.